Okay, so what we're going to get into now is called broadcasting. Now, when I think of the word broadcasting, I always try to think of something like some sort of machine that creates signals that go from one place to another, maybe like a television or Morse code. When you go ahead and do something on one end, it's going to cause a reaction on the other end. That's sort of like what broadcasting does, except in Scratch, it really has to do with sending different messages from one sprite to another sprite. So, here I have an undersea theme, and I think it's really funny that I have three smaller fish and one big fish, because this big fish kind of looks a little bit like a bully. So we're going to create a scene that sort of emulates that idea of the big fish being a bully and taking up all this space, and then all the smaller fish complaining about what the heck he's doing. Now, in order to broadcast, it's important to go ahead and note these three blocks right down here. When I receive, broadcast, and broadcast and wait. We're going to go through each of them one at a time so you can see exactly how you actually go ahead and send a signal from one sprite to another sprite. So let's go ahead and get started. Now first off, just to show you what I've done so far, I actually already have some blocks that I've set aside for actions on behalf of fish 3, the slightly bigger one right here. So when I click green flag, what happens is that my fish starts to kind of go around and around and around and around, and he's sort of going in the path of all the other fish, and he's being really annoying, which, frankly, I don't blame the other fish for complaining. So we're going to go ahead and fix that right now. We'll turn this off. Now the fish is about in the same place that it was before. So the way that I set this up was that I had a forever looping with move 20 steps, turn 5 degrees each time, and then if he hit the edge, he would bounce back, which is exactly what you saw him doing. He wasn't actually going off of the screen, he was staying right in the middle. So, when you broadcast, the way you do this is that you pick whatever sprite it is first that you actually want to go ahead and project out the message. That's what we call broadcasting. So to do that, I'm actually going to go ahead and have this fish right here be my broadcaster, meaning that when green flag is clicked on his particular scripts area, something is going to take place according to whatever blocks I put in the other fish's area. So we're going to go ahead and pull this one up, and the message that I'm going to put across is going to actually be something different. So I'll drop this down, and I'm going to go put new message, and I'm going to put stop swimming, exclamation point. That's going to be the title of the message that if I select that for the other fish is going to designate what the fish actually have to do. Okay, so we have stop swimming. So when green flag is clicked and this particular sprite is broadcasting this message, it sends a signal to wherever you might find this block when I receive and then whatever message you choose. Now, you could have this with the other sprites. You can actually also include it on this particular sprites page. He can actually send a message to himself and cause himself to do certain things based on whatever you choose. So let's say that in addition to just doing these actions, when green flag is clicked and it broadcasts this message, it's also going to go ahead and cause him to play a popping sound. Okay? So theoretically, he is sending a signal to himself, so it's going to cause him to actually go ahead and play the sound of pop. Let's go ahead and check it out. That one pop, just because he received that message, and he still continues to go around and do the same actions that he was doing before. Excellent. Okay, now, how does this affect the other sprites? Let me show you what you're going to do. Take this off, and we'll start with fish 2. Now, fish 2 does not have anything right now. It's completely blank. There's no blocks that have been placed. So we're going to go ahead and start off with that one that I just brought up. When I receive and then the message. So we'll do that. And then every time you press the green flag, it doesn't matter that it's happening on another sprite's set of commands, it's still going to go ahead and connect to this particular sprite. So I actually want this sprite to say something that means that he's sort of irritated that this giant fish is taking up all of his space in the whole ocean. So let's have him say something for 2 seconds. He's going to say, please stop swimming everywhere. Okay? Let's check it out and see what happens. Click. There you go. The other sprite technically broadcasted the message, and then the smaller purple fish received the message in turn. Didn't last too long though, so I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to change this, and let's have him say it for 10 seconds. Okay, now in the meantime, We'll give these other two fish commands as well. We'll also use the same block when I receive the stop swimming message, and let's have this fish say, get out of my way. And we'll also have him say it for 10 seconds. Last but not least, let's do this fish. We're gonna go ahead and use the same block when I receive. And then we'll go ahead and have him say, stop, in big capital letters with a lot of exclamation points. Oh my gosh, he just wants this fish to stop. And we'll change that to 10 seconds. All right, here we go. Are you ready to see how crazy irritated these fish are? Because I know I am. Green flag clicked. Bam. Going everywhere. The fish are annoyed. Please stop swimming. Get out of my way. Stop. And it just keeps on going until after 10 seconds, the messages disappear. And pause. Now, an interesting thing, though, about this is that there's actually a third block down here to note, which is broadcast and wait. What that means is that if you choose to use that for the starter of the broadcaster, they can actually broadcast that. And then when the other fish, they finish their message that they wanted to get across, whatever actions that we gave to them, then you can have your broadcaster sprite do something else after that. So let me show you what I mean. We're going to go ahead and we're going to go back to fish three. I'm going to take off broadcast stop swimming. And instead, I'm going to go ahead and put broadcast stop swimming and wait. Now, let's say this fish is kind of a macho fish. And instead of stopping all of the swimming that he's doing when the other fish complain, he just decides to get way bigger. So instead of just leaving it like this, after and wait, we're going to go ahead and add a change in looks. We're going to have him change size by 50. So he's going to get way bigger and just sort of be like, you know what, fish? I'm swimming. Leave me alone. Now, we don't have to do anything to the other sprites. Do you think you know why that is? That's right. They still have their actions already listed on their scripts area, and we don't need to change that because after 10 seconds, theoretically, that should be the finish of their actions and then the start of this one right here, the big fish's change size by 50 action. Here we go. Ready to test it out? Let's give it a try. All right, so same as before. Let's see what happens after 10 seconds. Bam! He got huge! He doesn't care what anybody's saying. He's just going to keep swimming around, and you know what? He's even bigger than before. And notice it's harder for him to get around because we still have him bouncing off the edges, but he's way bigger than he was before. Excellent. Oh, looks like he ate one of those poor little fishes. That's what you get for complaining. Now, at this point, when you go ahead and you try broadcasting, I'd like you to try doing different things with sending different messages to other sprites, but send them different ones. I used the same say for an amount of time block for each of these three sprites, but switch it up. Maybe you do a looks block. Maybe you do a sound block. Maybe you do a motion block. Try different things because broadcasting is the coolest way to get sprites to operate in relation to each other. You can also try it with things like sprites and backdrops, and that's something fun to explore if you want to see what sorts of things you can do with broadcasting.